back.
What the hell are you? You some new kind of guard? Like a tall boy? Can't be. Doctor, maybe? Just kidding. Assassin, maybe. Passing through, huh? Hoping to catch a ride on the plague wagon. A few come through here trying. And they fall and break their necks. But that won't stop you. You're almost there. It's pretty easy to get to the rooftops from here. You'll see the way. What do you want from me? To rob me? Looking for a quick roll in the mud? To rescue me? Well, I am not going anywhere. I came here all on my own, and I'm staying right here. Do you think it's better out there? I hate to break it to you, but this is it. This is Dunwall. What you see right here. Flooded district, estate district, anywhere else. It's all gonna be the same soon.
Must be in a basement.
There's no hospital. I told you that. You think they round people up because there's a cure?
They're city guards. They're supposed to protect people.
They did. They protect the healthy people from people like us, the sick ones.
I'm not that bad. Some people pull through, right? Don't they?
1 in 1,000. 10,000, probably.
Any chance I'll take. When I get out of there and get better, I'm going to do right this time. A fresh start. This time.
Goodbye, my boy.
Plague wagon's running every couple of minutes now. We just need to get on top of it and ride out of here.
Okay, great, smart guy. And what do we do when we hit the wall of light on what short get?
Make it 3 more months.
I see you've got the barrier up. About time.
Would have been done sooner if Clive's buggers didn't keep climbing back out.
Himself was stuck like a pig on some assassin's blade. What is going on up there?
Beautiful. The way you express yourself. Now shut up about it. I'm told there might still be plague carriers running around down here.
They poke their heads out sometimes, but I've had my hands so full with these diseased bastards coming out of the canal, I truly can't be bothered.
Well, the tall boys have orders to burn them out. If a Weeper gets out, then we've got the same problem 100 times over.
This is exactly why those jackasses who run the plague wagon need to gut the bodies before they throw them in here.
Well, when we get the lights back on, it'll be easier. We've got more tanks of whale oil on our way.
Finally. The last thing I need to do is crawl around looking for them.
Right. I'm headed back to civilization, or what's left of it. Have fun in here.
Oh, you bet. Because the tall boys are such great conversationalists.
wish I had a last swig of whiskey. You're the mask guy who's been taking down all the lords and ladies. No way through this gate unless you've got the sewer key. Only one place to get that key, and I wouldn't go there. Not for all the gold in Dunwall Tower. Not again. Maybe you could pull it off, though. Something attacked us in the distillery. It used the rats. I know it sounds crazy. And then it run back under the streets. So we come down here to kill it. Slackjaw leading the way. Went bad. I barely crawled out. Don't know what happened to Slackjaw. He had the sewer key, though. There was a fog, and then rats. Rats everywhere. Slackjaw chased him deeper into the sewers. Like a nightmare, something came to me.
and carve a pretty song on your bones.
Hey! Someone!
Look around. There's a cameo of the young girl. It's her. Destroy it with the gun. That's where she gets her powers. Throw it into the furnace, burn the cameo, and you kill her.
You can do it. Fury? Well, it's not enough. Hide me from his view. Hide me. You think you're going to save him? He's not worth it. Now Granny is going to kill you just like all the others. What will I write on your skull? That you were a fool!
For you.
Want to know something funny? When we were kids, we were all scared of Granny Rags. Thought she was a terrible witch. Then we grew up and figured she was just a sad old lady. We were right the first time. Now ain't that funny? I owe you. This won't even the score, but it's all I got left. Luck to you, Corvo.
Find your way into such interesting places, Corvo. At the eye of the storm, raging between Granny Rags and this man who has lived his whole life with a cleaver in one hand and a bottle in the other, crawling out of those flooded ruins, winding your way back to the pub where you last saw Emily. Where is she now? How does it feel now, knowing your allies betrayed you? Strange how there's always a little more innocence left to lose. And Dowd, you just killed the greatest assassin of the age. Did you do it for love of the Empress or Emily? Or was it the primal desire to rise above other men? Do you even know why?